prayer. So would you just join me for a second? Father, thank you so much for an opportunity like this. Thank you for Brooke's life, for her love for you and for her love for other people. It's always been evident within her. Her great desire to take every challenge that's been put before her and use it in a way that would encourage others, that would serve you and honor you. And Lord, we pray that in a morning like this, we could stop and we could be able to honor her and thank her and show the kind of respect that she deserves. Lord, we pray that you could bless our time together, our conversations, the snacks that we'll have, all of it, Lord, that you would receive great honor as one of your servants is lifted up as well. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Yeah. I'm actually a little nervous, so bear with me. I can't believe I'm nervous, so as much as I talk. So I want to thank everybody again for coming out to actually help me welcome Brooke to being Miss Wheelchair Arizona 2022. Wheelchair Arizona for 2020 and 2021. So now I am actually the state coordinator. I'm not a pageant person, that's not me. So I know, like, my crown and my sash. I said, oh Jesus, I forgot it at home. You know, normally I keep it in my car, but I take it out the car or whatnot, but it's like there's always behind tucked in somewhere because this is, you know. But I love the mission of what Miss Wheelchair is trying to do. Me and Brooke we're going to change everything. That is our thing. We're going to change everything. When I first met Brooke, I met Brooke at the 2020 pageant, I say thing or whatever, but that's when I first met Brooke. And Brooke blew me away. When I mean, I was just so captivated with everything that she said, everything that she did. I really was. And I mean, my niece, everybody's like, who was that? I mean, we was at our book station, just everything. And then I have had the pleasure to basically watch Brooke for the past 2 years. Okay, so when A asked me to be state coordinator, I was like, well, are y'all sure y'all want me to be state coordinator? That was the first thing. And the second thing, I was like, I needed to change some things because of how they were selecting the people and different things like that. Miss Wheelchair Arizona is about advocacy. That's what it's truly about, advocacy. It's about getting out there, letting people know that we're here. You know, we're a part of the community, we're doing things, and you know, just bringing awareness to whatever platform that we have. My platform was more of the, I retired from Social Security. And so my thing was like educating individuals on their benefits and just getting them out there, letting them understand that, you know, you can work, and if you don't want to work, it's okay, but this is how your benefits work and how it impacts you and how it helps you. And so that was my platform. I wish I could have done more, but I wasn't able to. But now since we have Brooke, Brooke's going to help. We're going to do this. I'm a very voiceful, I know I said it wrong, but that's just how I am. I'm very open, I don't bite my tongue about anything, and when I said I'm not holding, I think that the state coordinator should be the one that picks this person, or select this person for this position. And so me and Brooke had already talked about it before. I already knew what I was going to do. That's just me. I already knew what I was going to do. And I had already talked to Brooke about it. And she was all for it. Like, all for it. I was like, okay, I got you. So they approached me with it. Or I approached them. I sent them an email. And then they, you know, responded. And they were like, well, you have to do this. You have to do that. You have to do that. I was like, no. I already know who I want. And they were like, no, you have to have a couple people. I was like, no, I already know who I want. And so they were like, well, who is it? I was like, work around. I was like, if you don't know her, go on her website, get familiar with her, because she's going to be the person that I select. And I wanted to have full control. And then Brooke's going to do the bylaws, we're going to do everything together. and get this going. We want to, like I said, we want to change things. We want to make sure that everyone knows that, you know, we, I would say we, because, you know, I'm talking in general for individuals with disabilities, that we're here and we're smart, we're educated. You know, I always say to the children, I'm sorry, we're the best people. I'm that is just my, you know what I'm saying? I'm like, yeah, we're the best. We are the best. And we're very smart, you know, and I think people don't really, some people don't understand it, and some people just don't have a fear of what they do not know. And I think that that's what the thing is, and I think that that's what we're trying to do. We want to get out there. Brooke is going to do amazing things. Brooke stays on me. She holds me accountable. If anybody works with Brooke, Brooke, no, Brooke is up at 2 o'clock. I'm a night person, too. That's when my phone goes, ding, ding. And it's Brooke at like 1 to 2 o'clock in the morning. So she knows her stuff. She knows her stuff. She knows how to get. I've never done an event before. Brooke was like, this is what we do. So I thank God for bringing Brooke into my life, to be truly honest, because she reminds me of what we're doing this for. So our ultimate goal, our end goal, is to crown Brooke as Miss America. I got to get it right and tell you, of 2023. And that's the goal. And the goal, and once she gets there, gets to that platform, she will be able to, Miss Wheelchair Arizona, Miss Wheelchair World, they will send her all over. She won't have to pay for anything out of her pocket. She will go to every state and bring awareness to whatever platform she deems her. And so, you know, that's what we're going for. And Brooke can do it. You know, I'm in these meetings every month, which I don't like, Zoom meetings. Thank God for Zoom meetings. But I'm in these meetings every day. And, you know, all the things that each state are, that they say that they're doing, Brooke has already done it. You know, and I tell them, I was like, yeah, I mean, to be honest, the things that you guys are trying to do, Brooke has done it already. You know, and now she's on a whole nother level, you know. And just think, you seeing Brooke at every state, going to every state, speaking on her platform, getting her word out there. Wouldn't that be awesome? Yeah. Wow. Woo! That'd be so awesome. So that's our ego. And I love her support. I love you guys. I thank you guys for coming out here, supporting Brooke. You should see her list. Her list of her invites, and I was like, you know, when you invite people, sometimes they come, sometimes they don't. But I think only like 3 people, you know, and it was for other reasons or whatnot. So I appreciate you guys, because you know she's going to need your support. You know, the support is going to be needed, because she'll be going. The competition is in August, and it's a 3-day competition. And that competition, she's going to have to speak. She's going to have to do all. I mean, it's intensive. You know, she has to go to meetings. She's going to have like 3 gowns. I was yes. So she has to have like 3 gowns, and I think 1 casual wear. I was like, oh my Lord. You know, I got it good because I have to do it on Zoom, so I didn't do that. I had some jeans and a t-shirt. So I was kind of happy about that, but this time we're going to go to, it's going to be held in Michigan. So she has to go to Michigan, hotel flight, so all that stuff. We're going to fundraise for a lot of that. So a lot of the fundraising that we're going to be doing up until August is going to be to get Brooke to where she needs to be, to get her to Michigan, to get her her dressing, to get her, you know, whatever she needs to get to that event. That's what we're going to do. And if you guys know of anything or any event that you know of that for her to come and speak and bring awareness to what her platform is, you know, feel free to reach out to me and Brooke. So with that being said, I am going to open up for Jenny. So, all right. Yeah. Woo!
Jennifer Evans, and I'm the Ministry Relations Manager. we're a Christian disability ministry, and our mission is to glorify God as we communicate the gospel and equip the global church to evangelize, disciple, and serve people living with disability. So on behalf of Johnny Erickson Totter, our founder, and Johnny and friends, we just want to say congratulations, volunteers. And so I can get up there and share, but when Brooke does, she shares her testimony about how being a part of a church like Highlands that really places importance on not only people with disability being served, but them using their spiritual gifts to serve has really impacted her life and the importance of all churches welcoming. And so her and I are a great duo. And so she's hitting the ground running. We have our first one tomorrow at Faith Baptist Church in Glendale, so I'm excited about that. And I just really love Brooke's slogan, always assume competence. And I like to share my story about when I met Brooke, I was ignorant. I introduced myself to her, and because I didn't understand her, I assumed that she didn't understand what I was saying. And so I was kind to her, and I was like, great to meet you. And then she looked me up on Facebook later and sent me a message and said, oh, we both went to the Walter Cronkite School at ASU at the same time, and then we got to know each other and started a friendship. So I think that's one of my goals, is to help churches to do this, to teach people to assume competence. So Brooke is such an inspiration. I'm glad to call her a friend, and we're just so excited about what you're going to be able to do for the disability community at this time. Yeah. So thank you.
Noon, my friends. It is a blessing beyond words to see you all here to celebrate this honor with me today. Even though I have been planning for and anxiously anticipating this day for about 6 months, it still doesn't feel quite real. Wondering if someone's going to come wake me up from an awesome dream. But then, I think back on the 6-year journey it's taken me to get here, with all its frustration and pain, and the reality of my situation sets in. In the trials I've endured on this journey have taught me one thing, is that the best way to build relationships, cultivate fulfilling opportunities, and advocate for positive change in our communities is to share our stories with one another. You see, at any given moment, one typically able person will begin communicating with another, under the automatic assumption that the other can comprehend everything being said. However, this is not always true when a typically physically able person endeavors to engage someone with a disability. Culture has conditioned people to incorrectly assume there is an automatic correlation between one's physical limitations and mental competency. This perception needs to change urgently. As an example, during two of my three previous pageants as a contestant, my ability to fulfill the stated goal of Miss Wheelchair Arizona was discounted because of my speech impairment. The judges weren't willing to let go of their preconceived notions of the perfectly spoken title holder and really listen to my story or see the value in my background. But after I competed for the first time and lost a tiebreaker, I was told point blank that I wasn't chosen because the judges assumed my speech impairment would hinder me from doing well at nationals. I was deeply offended, and quite frankly appalled at that way of thinking. Because my voice sounds different from other title holders doesn't mean people won't be encouraged by listening to my story and my mission won't have a positive impact on the disabled community. Yeah. The reason I titled my platform, Always Assume Competence, Eliminating Stigma and Cultivating Opportunities for People with Disabilities Through Personal Storytelling. Should never avoid communicating with someone else simply because their body mechanics are unfamiliar. The able person should strive to approach a person with a disability the same way they would any other. Know them by asking questions, seeking out common interests, and listening to their experiences. Cognitive challenges to become apparent, find out what accommodations need to be made. Even many of those with cognitive limitations can sense when someone is being patronizing. As my friend Missy, who happens to be the Disability Ministry Director here at Highlands, always asks in her volunteer trainings, what's more harmful? The able person making the presumption that a person with a disability can understand everything said to and happening around them when they really can't? On noticing another person's disability and jumping to conclusion that their physical limitations automatically makes them not cognitively aware? People the benefit of the doubt is always the best practice. We're all created in God's image. He has given each of us specific gifts for a dedicated purpose, regardless of disability, as it states in 1 Peter 4:10-11, and that makes us all worthy of human dignity and meaningful communication. Throughout the history of humanity, there has always been one dominant form of communication by which we interact, and that is telling stories. We all do it, every day, several times a day. One at any age, in any condition or circumstance can appreciate a good story. Only believe that this is true because on some level every person wants to be acknowledged, accepted and treated as equal by society at large, no matter how they may protest otherwise. Especially true for those of us in the disabled community. It's the most basic principle behind the Universal Access Movement, which strives to provide access to all public facilities to all people on all mobility levels. Some able-bodied people describe people with disabilities as having special needs, but different does not constitute special. We are not asking for anything more than what's equal. Equal care. Equal respect. Know that as members of this vibrant and ever-growing community, we are passionate about our shared goals. My opinion, the most effective way to initiate the positive advancements in equality, for which we are always advocating, is to change the perceptions of our able-bodied peers on a personal level, telling one story at a time. Each unique story will come greater mutual understanding, which leads to more open doors for new opportunities. The challenge of finding common ground starts with dispelling another's misguided assumptions. We must work to let others see our individual characters at all times. Each person's story is different, and so are the ways it can be told. My own stories in many various forms, each one as intensely personal as the next. Example, I'm able to connect with those that watch me dance or do Pilates by explaining that while I have to rely on my power chair for my general mobility, I still enjoy being physically active and pushing the limits of my body. Similarly, anyone who reads my written work will quickly realize I have many of the same thought processes, emotions, desires and goals as any other 30-something able-bodied woman, even though my speech may be difficult to understand. The more I've utilized my life stories as anecdotes for inspiration and motivational speeches and as supporting evidence for policy change and advocacy events. As Ms. Wheelchair Arizona 2022, I plan to advocate the importance of personal storytelling by continuing to speak and give presentations at schools, conferences, churches, and other events, encouraging people to discover the power, growth, and blessings that come from sharing one's life experiences. I pray I can become a voice of hope for people who struggle to be heard themselves. I'll also continue to promote my books and my speaking engagements as an encouragement and professional example for others. Our personal stories, however they come, are our most powerful tools. They will take us farther than any combination of facts and figures. An intense desire to assist others in sharing theirs. The main vehicle for advancing my platform will be growing my community connections and partnerships through my creative storytelling services ministry called Brooks Butterfly Touch, BBT. The mission of BBT is to illustrate, teach, and implement narrative storytelling techniques from a Christ-centered perspective to accomplish three main goals. 1. Develop better communication methods for one's experiences and abilities to create new opportunities, personally and professionally. 2. Inspire hope and emotional healing from hardships while promoting a participant's sense of purpose. Eliminate societal prejudices, stigmas, and misconceptions of those that are differently able to or face profound adversity, mental illness, disease, abuse, tragic loss, etc. This will be done by continuing to teach my Transforming the Heart of Your Story workshop to various community groups. Finally, I plan to make as many public appearances as possible and also create enriching social media content to advance the goal of community acceptance of people with disabilities. Volunteer efforts will focus on my partnership with Johnny and Friends Arizona as part of their disability ministry training team. These workshops, I will share my experiences trying to find acceptance, actively participate in, and serve the church community within the constraints of cerebral palsy, thereby offering insight and advice to minister volunteers seeking to meaningfully engage participants with various limitations. And with the trainings, I will also continue leading a biblical support group for adults with physical disabilities here at Highlands Church. Group provides a safe place for adults with physical disabilities to find emotional support, be encouraged in their daily challenges, and study the Bible as we help to build each other's faith and trust in Jesus Christ. Our spring session begins Thursday, January 20th at 5 o'clock. The link is always available for those who can't join us in person. An invite card on my ministry table. Please take a few if you, or anyone you know, would be interested in coming. Activities will help me in achieving the goal of winning the 2023 Ms. Wheelchair America title at the National Pageant in Grand Rapids, Michigan. It's important for me to fulfill my duty of making appearances throughout the state and compete at nationals. I need to raise at least $10,000 to cover all travel expenses and fees. I would be humbled and beyond grateful for your prayers and donations. Anything you can give is a blessing, because it will allow me to share my story, bless and encourage others throughout the country. There is a donation basket here, or if you prefer, you can give on the Ms. Wheelchair Arizona 2022 GoFundMe page. Ask me about other mobile giving options, as well. Today, you may also donate directly to Ms. Wheelchair America, Incorporated in my honor, and your donation will be applied towards my pageant entry fee, which is $2,000. Make sure to designate Arizona on your donation. The key element in stories that affect change are the characters. The important element in any story with the power to affect change is the voice behind it. It's the thing about our favorite stories. It's not the plots that we remember forever. It's the dynamic characters that touch souls and make permanent impressions in the mind. I look forward to enriching Arizona's story over the next year. In doing so, I must offer my deepest gratitude to those without whom I wouldn't be sitting here today. They who are the ones who have prayed and cried with me and prayed some more over the last 6 years, my cheerleaders, my extra hands and feet. Teach me to believe and trust just a little bit more. All a blessing beyond words. Again for coming to celebrate the start of my greatest chapter yet. Don't to stop by my ministry table to check out my books and information about my workshops, presentations, and the one-of-a-kind Always Assume Competence t-shirts made by my sweet friend Robin Jensen.
She said what they had actually initially, when she did run, I get emotional about it because I'm so passionate about school disabilities. And when I look at Brooke, I look at you, we're no different. And for an agency or an organization that's supposed to be a platform for us, you know, can say that to her. I didn't know. I mean, I guess that's the reason why they gave me so much pushback. But like I said, that's why you're ready for me. You know, I'm going to be Brooke's biggest, one of her biggest support system, one of her biggest fan. I always call myself, like what they'll say, I'm a pit bull because I kick down doors. You know, I'm going to be there by her side through the whole thing. I'm going to make sure that this pageant is run fairly, and that everything that Brooke has done in her lifetime be voiced there. That's all we need. A lot of people, like, go on the Facebook page, share it, you know, so we can get the word out. A lot of Brooke's events will be posted on there also, and that's how we're gonna get everything out. You know, everybody knows the power of social media. I mean, I've been TikToking lately, so we're gonna do some TikToks. But you know, everybody knows the power of social media and things of that nature. So if you guys can just like go like, share, like I said, the GoFundMe page is on there also. Brooke's portion of it is the $2,000, but also Brooke, you know, her she needs assistance. So we want to make sure that we raise funds for the people that to be able to go and make it a great experience for her also. So that's why we're raising the additional money. And I really, really do appreciate everybody coming and helping us, you know, crown Brooke. So with further ado, if I can have our parents come up.
Is perfect, and I'm so grateful that I get to be a part of this time, and that you provided this tribe to her. So I pray that each one of us continues to support her and encourage her along this journey. Lord, anybody who knows Brooke knows how much she loves you and that it is her desire to glorify you in everything that she says and does. So as she wears this new crown as Miss Wheelchair Arizona, Lord, I pray that you always remind her that it is the crown she wears as your child that is the most important. And that as she heads out to make an impact on the world, that she uses both those crowns to make an impact for your kingdom. Lord, as she heads to Nationals, we are so excited that she gets to share her platform of Assuming Competence. We ask that you are with her in a powerful way and that you open the minds and the ears of all those who will hear her story. Lord, we just pray that she is able to powerfully share that you have a plan and purpose for everyone. And even though someone may not speak, that doesn't mean that they don't have something powerful to say. Lord, we ask that you put a hedge of protection around Brooke as she heads on this journey. We ask that you provide for her financially, that you provide for her emotionally, you provide for her physically, and you provide for her spiritually. We just are so excited to see what you're going to do with her life, and we again ask that each one of us here continue to support her as she travels on this journey that you have. We ask you to guide her, we ask you to guard her, we ask you to protect her and everything that she says and does, Lord. And we ask these things in your precious son's name. Amen.
Amen.
You fall so far, you should be ashamed of yourself. So I was ashamed of myself. The lies I believe, they got some roots that run deep. I let them take a hold of my life, I let them take control of my life.